Okay. Now we have the button, we have the callback. You now know where to find the callback, the IRQ handler. This is everything perfect. Now we can, for example, play with the IRQ and I show you new feature. For example, I now decided that I don't want to leave this IRQ handler. I want here, after I press the button, stay in this callback forever, and I want to toggle with the let here inside this function every each 1 second. Then I here put the while. Sorry, I stop the debugging. Will be better. I return to my perspective. Put here the while one and I put here the delay function. I put here the 1000 to create the 1 second delay. Then what we expect from this function? We expect that if we press the button, we jump here into the circuit, and we will toggle with the LED each 1 second. Then we can try this. We will save the file. I try to build my file. We jump into debugger. Yes, I went into debugging interface. I run it. I press it, and what happens? The LED is only on, it's not blinking. Now why? This can happen because this function, this delay function, using how the delay works, it's used with the sysTick. The sysTick keeps the 1 millisecond time base for the delay, but the sysTick operates through the interrupt. If you remember, the sysTick is here. Then what happened? That why the sysTick not entering the interrupt? The problem is that we can have only one running interrupt at a time. This means only one interrupt can be active. This means that if we are in this interrupt, we cannot enter the sysTick interrupt. Then we are blocked and this delay function not work because we are stuck here to waiting for the sysTick to count up. Then what is happening? Then what to solve this? For this, the NVIC is have the second functionality. We can look here. We can hear the priorities. We can have here the preemption priorities and the sub priorities. And also on some M3 and M4 core devices, you can set also how many bits are used for the preemption priorities and how many bits for the sub priorities. In our case, we will use all the 4 bits for the preemption priorities. What is different? The preemption priority mean that if the interrupt which is with the lower number, it want to pend or want to be active, it will stop the interrupt with the lower number and start executing the interrupt with the higher number. This mean the preemption. The sub priority means that only when the interrupts start in the same time, it will be decided that the first interrupt will be the interrupt with the lower number. In our case, we have the XT, and you can see all the priorities have the same number, also the sysTick here has also number. Then to allow the sysTick to run, the sysTick need to have lower number than our XT. And we here have the sysTick have the 0. This is the lowest value. In our case, we can put number between 1 to to 15. Because we have only two interrupts, I select one. Okay, I click to apply. Okay, I regenerate my code. I don't need to open my folder. I open the, this one. Okay, we can store everything. We can build it. And we can expect what will happen. If everything will work as we expect, then after I change these priorities, the xstate, the systake have now the higher permission parity. This means then when I am in the lower priority interrupt, which means this one, and I waiting here, then still the systake have the lower priority, it's the higher priority for him, lower number is higher priority, then I can always access this systake interrupt handler. And I here build successfully my project. I run the debugger. I'll go to the perspective. I run my code. And when I press the button, I can see that my LED is blinking. This means our configuration is working. Then don't please not forget on the interrupt priorities, because it's sometimes very, very important that one interrupt can have the higher priority than the other interrupts. And you always need to check during your design of your application which interrupt will be higher. And you need to be sure that you cannot block your application in the interrupt. On the end, put the delay into interrupt is not a clear solution. It's not recommended. The interrupts may be as short as possible. Then never put the delays into interrupt.